Today in the world of cannabis, former President Trump issued clemency to some individuals serving cannabis offense sentences. An Illinois lawmaker who was a major player in passing cannabis legislation in the state resigns. And the DEA warns of pot smurfs in Texas and other states. It's Friday, January 22nd, and this is your Trichomes Morning Buzz.
Broadcasting live from the Trichomes.com studios in Southern California, it's time for your Morning Buzz. We bring you late-breaking news that keeps you up to date with what's happening in the cannabis industry.
First up, in a report by Ganjapreneur, in the waning hours of his last night as president of the United States, Donald Trump issued a multitude of over 100 pardons, including 11 individuals serving federal prison sentences for cannabis offenses, six of which are serving life sentences. The clemency is a direct result of advocacy for cannabis activists, celebrities, and a bipartisan group of lawmakers. A letter sent to then-President Trump in November 2020 included a list of incarcerated individuals who they felt were to be prioritized for pardons. Of them, Craig Cesal was granted clemency for his cannabis offense life sentence. Many, many marijuana activists have worked for years to make this happen for me, with the Last Prisoner Project helping recently with my reintegration into society, said Cesal. My release and clemency is due solely to the efforts of many marijuana activist groups, and I thank each and every one of them.
And next, the Chicago Tribune reports that Illinois Senator Heather Steens, a key lawmaker in passing cannabis legalization in the state, has announced the resignation of their Senate seat effective January 31st. Senator Steens has cited family obligations, including caring for her mother with Alzheimer's disease, as a reason for her resignation, and said, "I really care deeply about the city and the state, and I'm sure I'll stay involved." Illinois' cannabis legislation was lauded for focusing on establishing social equity and diversifying the predominantly white cannabis industry. Heather has been a valiant partner in forcing the state government to address the historic racism and discrimination that has left too many of our families behind, said Toy Hutchinson, Pritzker's top marijuana advisor and Steen's former Senate colleague. Heather's voice and leadership in that ongoing battle will be missed.
Last up, in a report by News for San Antonio, the DEA said that individuals they've labeled as pot smurfs are working to obtain cannabis in other states and bring it back to Texas and other states where it remains illegal. Smurfs, or loopers, is slang for people who travel to dispensaries, purchase the maximum amount of cannabis permitted, and sell it illegally across state borders, according to the DEA. What is also occurring, the black market marijuana of someone traveling to one of those states legitimately purchasing marijuana from a dispensary, going to multiple dispensaries or stores, then smuggling that marijuana back into another state, said Dante Sorinella, the assistant special agent in charge of the Drug Enforcement Administration in the San Antonio District. The DEA added that while Smurfs are making a substantial amount of money, so too are law enforcement organizations in Texas through asset seizure funds on confiscated cannabis.
And that was today's Buzz. Thanks for listening. For more cannabis news and insights from industry professionals and a place to discuss these stories and others, visit trichomes.com.
And be sure to catch up with all of our other cannabis industry-related podcasts like Hash It Out, The High Ground, or Careers in Cannabis, wherever you get your podcast. For trichomes.com, I'm Devin Liao.
And I'm David Fortin. Have a great weekend.